Understanding combustion through images. You will see several illustrative films on gas, liquid and solid combustion processes. Flames that arise from an initial premixing of fuel and gas are called premix flames. Flames where mixing occurs at the flame are called diffusion flames. And combustion acoustics is due to the coupling between heat released by combustion and acoustic waves generated in the medium. About 70% of the videos are from experiments conducted in the laboratory. Rest is from public domain. This needs a one-sided open tube with an arrangement for filling the tube with the gaseous mixture of known composition and sparking at the top. Note that the stoichiometric flames are faster than lean or rich mixtures. Rich mixtures have actually cellular structures. The flame speed is representative of the reactivity of the fuel air mixture. The steady combustion of the flow of premixed mixture through a Bunsen burner shows a flame that becomes more intensely turbulent till it cannot sustain. It actually blows off then. Its lift and then it blow off. Steady combustion, flashback and blow off when the flow of premixed gases is decreased slowly through tubes of different diameters. The flame blows off in the smallest diameter tubes since the quench distance of the mixture is comparable to the diameter of the tube. It flashes back in the other three tubes. At the same power level, the premix flame volume is about half of a diffusion flame and hence the heat release rate of a premix flame is higher accordingly. Premix flames have a higher heat release rate because fuel and oxidizer are initially well mixed. A fire rill is a combination of concentrated heat source coupled with organized source of angular momentum, either from wind shear or from fire's convection column, that must help create large swirl velocities as air is entering into the fire plume. In the laboratory experiments, fans can be arranged to provide swirling flows. Or a rotating table with meshed cylindrical structure providing a source of angular momentum can be used. The ultra-high speed film shows the pressure variation caught by the combustion in a four-stroke engine. The movement of the cylinder is clearly visible, as is the flame front of the combustion around the spark plug. Thank you. The ultra-high speed film shows the combustion structure inside the cylinder as a Schlieren picture. Schlieren photography picks out the density gradients inside the flow. Note the complex turbulent flame propagation inside the combustion space of the cylinder. Diffusion flame with increased flow from burner stabilized mode to lift and blow off. Diffusion flame is obtained by causing the flow of a fuel, in this case LPG, through the Bunsen burner. Air for the combustion enters by diffusion. As the flow rate is increased, the flame height increases nearly linearly. It also lifts off from the edge of the tube. The height then levels off with the flow becoming turbulent. The jet entrains air from outside, and beyond some flow rate, the flame acquires partly premixed character. With increased flow rate, the flame blows off. Flameless combustion. Normally, fuel jet and air or oxidizer surround each other. This leads to combustion with visible flame. By arranging the fuel and oxidizer jets at a distance from each other and making the jet speeds high, of the order of 100 to 300 meters per second, the jets entrain the high temperature products of combustion to dilute the fuel and oxygen fraction with increased temperature of the jets. Reaction begins at high temperature, typically 1000 degrees centigrade and more, and the combustion process will occur in a mode close to stirred reactor. Such a combustion process will be non-sooty and the flame will be near transparent, hence the name flameless combustion mode. The high speed jets on the right or for flameless combustion. Gas hydrates or methane enclosed in a crystalline cage of water molecules formed deep under the sea, implying very high pressures. As you see in the last picture, methane burns with ice slowly melting away. It is the water present on the pond that lets it be held at the pump. In this experiment, we observe that the flame is a conductor of electricity. The flame is a conductor of electricity since it is composed of charged particles, ions and electrons. High voltage of 1.1 kV is established between two electrodes with sharp ends. When the flame is brought such that it covers the fine ends of the electrodes, the circuit gets closed, current flows and the bulb glows red. When the flame is drawn away, the circuit is open.